How powerful is Saitama's serious punch? Saitama, better known as One Punch Man, is a character designed not to be taken seriously. His power level goes way beyond 9,000 because his strength comes from satire and not any backstory. And so we've never really seen this incredibly formidable hero, though he doesn't look it, unleash his full potential. He will simply be stronger, probably, than the strongest enemy he faces. But I think with a little bit of math and a little bit of anime investigation, we can at least calculate what happens when Saitama gets serious. For our analysis, we're going to consider season 1 of the One Punch Man anime. In it, the most serious showing of Saitama's strength is during his fight against Lord Boros, a cycloptic alien invader who carries immense power inside his Ken doll-like body. Let's take the fight blow by blow until we get to serious punch levels to see if we can get an idea of just how strong Saitama can be. We're gonna go step by step through this fight because, by the rules of anime, whatever enemy attack that you can withstand, shake off, or deflect, you must simply be stronger than. Nice try. This is why we have to evaluate all of Lord Boros' attacks just to see how strong Saitama has to get. And Lord Boros starts out strong. The first attack that One Punch Man has to shrug off is a blast from Boros that the Cyclops claims can completely vaporize enemies, bones and all. Since Lord Boros is always talking about the energy bound within him, how much physical energy would it take to completely vaporize a person? There are a few ways we could tackle this question. The most direct approach might be a brute force method, where we take the relative amounts of everything inside the average human body, all the calcium, all the protein, all the water in a human body, and see just how much energy it would take to take those solids or liquids and turn them directly into gas. Going through some tedious calculations that I'm not going to show you because then we would just be padding out this episode like we were Dragon Ball Z or something, you get around 3 billion joules, 3 gigajoules worth of energy needed to vaporize an entire person, bones and all. This is about the amount of energy in your average lightning bolt. But we should at least check this number, our more brute force approach, with a more practical one. According to the Federation of British Cremation Authorities, it takes around 300 kilowatt hours of natural gas and electrical energy to reduce a person completely to ash, to vaporize almost all of them. And it just so happens that if you convert this value, you get just about 1 gigajoule, which means our numbers from 2 separate approaches are in decent agreement, which means our values get an S ranking. But this is the low end of the energy on display during this fight. Because next Lord Boros pumps Saitama to the moon, and this would take even more energy. You've probably heard of the term escape velocity before. It's a theoretical velocity at which you'd have to launch something off the surface of a body, like a planet in space, in order to move that object infinitely far away, such that it is always moving outside of the gravitational influence of that body, always slowing down but never approaching zero and never falling back in. On Earth, that value is around 11.2 kilometers per second. Now, you can use this theoretical velocity to get at how much energy you would need to put into something to punt it off the surface of a planet like Saitama. And you can use either side of this equation to do so, either the kinetic energy needed to do that with escape velocity or how much work you would have to do against the pull of gravity in order to pull something off of a planet. Ignoring the atmosphere, the amount of energy Lord Boros would have to put into his knee and then into Saitama's body is around 4 gigajoules. However, if Lord Boros gets OPM to the moon in just 3 seconds, as we see in the anime, this value spikes to 700 petajoules. That's more energy than the sun hits the Earth with in total every second. But Saitama shrugs this attack off too, which means that his serious move has to be even stronger than this. What? Now? Ugh, okay. 1, 2, 3, 100. Boros' final move is a bit harder to put into real-world terms, but it should give us a point of comparison for Saitama's final fist. In the final phase of the Lord Boros fight, the extraterrestrial being unleashes an incredibly powerful attack, his final move. But what this final move is supposed to do depends on which version of One Punch Man you're looking at or reading. In the English dub, for example, of the anime, he says blasting you and this planet to hell. In the English manga, however, he says wiping you away along with the planet's surface. And the same confusion exists in the Japanese versions. For this analysis, we're gonna focus on the version where he says wiping away an entire planet's surface, simply because it's more interesting to me. If you were an evil alien looking to wipe out the surface of an entire planet, how much of that planet would you actually be destroying? Well, I've drawn Earth here to scale with Earth's crust, the thickness of Earth's crust, which I would consider to be Earth's surface. And as you can see here at 1/50 millionth scale, the Earth's crust is almost nothing. It's like the skin on the grape that is the Earth. So if you are going to destroy a planet's surface, relatively speaking, although it would take an obscene amount of energy, you wouldn't be destroying all that much. Now, what does wipe out the surface of a planet really mean? Well, if we're talking about a big anime-style fight, I'm guessing Lord Boros wants to vaporize the surface of the planet like he wanted to vaporize Saitama's bones. And if that's the case, we need how much energy it will take to turn Earth rock into sick Earth rock vape. Just like ice can go from ice to water to steam if you add enough heat energy, rock can go to rock vapor if you add enough heat energy. So if you wanted to vaporize some section of Earth's crust, you would just need to know the total amount of heat needed. However, the Earth is a very complicated thing with many different materials and many different temperatures, and you would have to do an equation like this with specific heats, heats of fusion, heats of vaporization, for every single different material and how much mass and its percentages. It's very complicated. So instead, we are just going to broadly approximate. Estimating and approximating, I think a decent value for how much energy it will take to vaporize 1 cubic meter of Earth's crust will be around 25 gigajoules. The numbers are so large here, even if we're off by just a little bit, it won't matter all that much. Now, all we have to do is apply our approximation to the entirety of Earth's surface. If Lord Boros launched an attack to vaporize the entirety of Earth's surface, it would have to have enough energy to completely erase what amounts to about 1% of Earth's volume. Do the math with our values and you find that the total energy required to vaporize all of Earth's surface is 1,000,000 septillion joules, which is a ridiculous amount of energy, surely ridiculous enough to be associated with a character like Saitama. But like we did before, let's just check our numbers. If this is the amount of energy to vaporize 1% of Earth, what would 100% of the energy be? By simple multiplication, the value would then be 10 to the 32 joules, and this just happens to be almost exactly the gravitational binding energy of Earth. How much energy you'd have to put into Earth to remove all of its pieces out into infinity or destroy it. This is almost the value that you always hear discussed when we talk about the Death Star. So our value actually makes a confusing amount of sense, and therefore, this is the amount of energy Saitama's serious punch would have to deflect. And so, by the rules of anime, Saitama's serious punch has to be at least this strong. Strong enough to evaporate entire sections of a planet like it was nothing. One punch! Now that we have comparisons for serious punch energies, we can investigate how the move actually works. What? It's not weird. The serious punch, unlike other anime-style final moves, doesn't look like some kind of blast of plasma energy. Rather, it looks like a gust of air, or at least this time it looks like a gust of air, the same kind of gust that put a hole in a mountain behind Genos that one time. So now let's focus on the effect this move actually has, parting clouds across the entire planet. I think there is a real connection to real-world energies here. This is a very simple diagram of a volcano. Every so often, a volcano structured like this can start to build up gases near the top, mostly water vapor and CO2. When the pressure in this plug of air gets high enough in what's called a Strombolian eruption, this air gives way and creates enormous pressure waves in the surrounding atmosphere that, yes, can move and create clouds. Here is a recent example caught in Japan. Look how the air compresses and stretches the atmosphere with the pressure waves such that it creates clouds instantaneously. And here's another mind-blowingly beautiful example captured in 2014 in Papua New Guinea. Look how the pressure waves almost deform the weather exactly like One Punch Man was trying to exaggerate. These are serious punches of air. Looking to the volcano literature, you can use an equation like this to estimate the total energy of an eruption based on the final height of the plume that it spits out. The final height for the plume from that eruption in Papua New Guinea that we just looked at was 18,000 meters, 18 kilometers. And if that's the case, that means that this eruption that moved and created clouds had around 10 petajoules worth of energy. Now, by anime logic, if Saitama can force air around and from his fist more energetically, trillions of times more energetically than this eruption that moved and created clouds, then it's anime plausible that his serious punch could do exactly what we see in the anime and the manga. He would be a bald, yellow-suited volcano of a man who is just a hero for fun. So, just how strong is One Punch Man's serious punch? Well, at least in season one of the anime, behind Saitama's fist has to be an eruption of energy, a gloved volcano of satirical strength that can wipe out entire swaths of a planet's surface at the very least. Imagine if he actually hit something. It would do a lot more than just part the Saitama. Because science. I'm fine with it. Thank you so much for watching, Kristen. If you want to suggest ideas for future episodes, you can follow me and Because Science here at these handles. Also, we are on to episode 4 of The Science of Mortal Kombat. We just got to The Science of Get Over Here. You're going to want to check it out because there's a rope involved.